we're coming to the end of another parami, you know? We've almost mastered this parami now, determination or resolve, yeah, resolve, resolution, and yeah, tomorrow will be the last talk on that. So a few more words about resolution. And for me, it really comes down so much of the practice, of our practice, of my practice. Yeah. Comes down to a few simple invitations, a few simple propositions, a few simple resolutions, a few simple determinations. Although that word determination can feel a little heavy at times, a little intense. I like intention better, deep intentions. There are only a few deep intentions that go along with this practice that keep it alive. We want to make it fancier. We always want to make things more complex than what they are. And we bring our complexity right into meditation. Oh, it's got to be more complicated than this. It can't be just this. It's not that simple. But the practice, in some respects, is simple and is inviting us to simply turn toward our experience in a different way, with a different kind of commitment, with a different kind of humble commitment, you could say, to turn toward the simplicity, toward the obvious, you know, toward the obvious. And it's so much about remembering to remember, both on the cushion, but also in our daily life, remembering to remember that it's amazing to be here. It's amazing to be in these bodies breathing. It's another amazing day. Today is another amazing day. This is another amazing opportunity to be with all of you, to recognize how incredible it is, the so-called ordinariness of our lives, and to ratchet it up a little bit, and to simply realize how special it is and how it's not always going to be so. We're not always going to be here. You know, it's not just, we saw someone this weekend who said, you know, it's one of the Western propositions. Everywhere else in the world, people know they're going to die. In the West, here's the thing that we know. Everybody else is going to die except for me. And I thought, that's so right on. That's so right on. That is the way it is for us. As that Zen master said when he came back from his long retreat, and his students gathered close, and he said, "We want to know the deepest truth that you found on your retreat." And the teacher said, "Well, yeah, this is the deepest truth that I found on my retreat. The deepest truth, that we're all going to die, but none of us are living our lives as if that were so." That we're forgetting all of the time, or we're thinking the big thing or the big transformative thing is somewhere out here. Maybe, what is it out here? And forgetting, no, it's right here. It's stopping it, going after it out here and realizing it's all a sandcastle all the time. It's not going to last. And it's enhancing that realization with appreciation, with gratitude, with the sense of how we're not always going to be here, but we are here now. This breath is here now. You know, it's like that. It's like that. And it's not about staying in that space. Oh, that's what it really is. Now I have to start every moving through the world all the time as if that's, it's all precious, every single moment. No, no, no. That's another setup for us. That's another setup. That's not going to happen. Okay. But we can remember to remember to light up a few moments, as many moments. We can determine to do this. We can vow to do this. We can intend to make magic out of the ordinary by raising it up, not by raising it up in some superhuman special, but like, oh my goodness, like walking into the room, like we do every day. Susan and I do this every day, 20, 30 times a day, 40 times a day. We'll walk into a room and there are our cats, not same as it ever was. Not, oh, just, of course I know this. I know how they behave. I know how, no, no. That's precisely the habit that keeps us from enlivening our lives more. It's more like, look at you. Every time we walk in the door, I should have a recording of this. I keep threatening to recording this. We come home to this amazing home. And the first thing is our two cats are in the window. And I hear Susan's voice, hey, you two, how are you kids doing? What have you been up to? What have you been up to, you two? What's going on? Right? Like it's a miracle. Like it's a miracle. Like that. Like that. You know, I love that. I love that. My favorite thing about the Peter Pan thing is Tinkerbell. Tinkerbell with her wand, you know, and she goes around just lighting things up. She doesn't say, there's another ordinary thing. Uh-huh. Got it. Know it. Been there. Done that. So what? Whatever. Where's the next really beautiful thing? That's not what she's doing. She's going, bing, bing. Yeah, we don't stay there 24/7, but if we can remember to do this 10 times a day, 100 times a day, we do it at least 100 times a day. For one breath, for one moment. Like, oh, how amazing is this? How amazing is this? How amazing is this? Yeah. We can do that right now, right? You know, you can do that right now. We can do that in any moment. Oh, just listening to Bill again. It's almost. Oh, that makes sense. That makes sense. Now light it up. How cool is this that we're all here together right now, that all of you formed the intention. This didn't happen by accident. You all had to make the effort to get here. And isn't it cool that we're all here? You know, just like that. Here we are again. Here we are again. Yeah. We got on another plane yesterday, you know, and got in too late to come in for the daily sit yesterday morning. Every time I take off, I don't know about you, every time I take off, I go, this might be it. Not in a morbid way, but it's like, oh, who knows? And when we land, I go, oh my goodness, I'm still here. We're still here. We're still here. You know? It's really like that. It's like more moments to enhance the present moment. It's an enhancement. It's an enhancement. It's making richer. It's more fully inhabiting. It's bringing more of ourselves to this moment. More of ourselves to this moment. You know, we can do that in a moment. We all know how to do that, but we forget to do that. Or we think, no, it's got to be more than that. It's not more than that. It's doing that 100 times a day so that we stop taking things for granted. We start seeing things a little bit more freshly, a little bit more of the time while we're still all here. We have a dear friend who used to live with us, who's come back here to be here for a month because her mother's dying just across the way. We're not going to be here forever. But we're here now. We're here now. You know, I think of alchemy. Remember alchemy? We don't hear about that much anymore. Alchemical transformation. What is alchemy? It's transform. What's the metaphor of alchemy? Transforming base metals into gold. Transforming base metals into gold. So much of this of meditation is transforming base experience, what ordinary experience. Oh, it's just ordinary. I need to make it something else. This is how you make it into something else. Like with Tinkerbell's wand, you go, bing, it's something else. It's gold now. That's how you transform base metal into gold. That's how we, moment by moment, when we can remember to remember, start to transform some of the base metal of the way we perceive our experience into gold, into precious, into miracle, into remembering, remembering. Ah, ah. Yeah, yeah. So to me, that is the resolve of resolves. And as part of it, it's the resolve, you know, I'll tie this in just for a moment. Part of it, of course, is the resolve to practice regularly. And here you all are. Because it's hard to have more of those moments if we don't take some time each day to just be with ourselves and to practice more deeply appreciating this being human. And to be welcome a little bit more of the things that haven't been welcomed, to transform some of this flotsam and jetsam into gold, not by getting rid of it, but by going, this too is part of this being human. You know, so we do that on the cushion, we're more likely to be able to do that in our lives. At least a few times a day, a few more times a day. However many times you do it, the determination to it, just do it a few more times. That's our, that'd be our invitation for you. It's my invitation to myself. This is a Dharma talk for myself too. You know, we always need more reminders than instructions. Really, at the end of the day. Yeah. Okay.